Greetings and salutations, friends. It's your boy Nick Shea coming back with another video. Today is something I've been needing to get off my chest for a little bit now. You saw the title. This is not clickbait. And I failed my Princeton final. Finals were about a month ago, and when I opened up my transcript to check my grades, I was kind of just devastated, shocked, confused, pissed, and there's a lot of things that I was feeling that I will kind of go through today. The reason I wanted to make this video is to just kind of show that yes, I am a Princeton student, but I'm also just a human being. I make mistakes, I fail, I fuck up, and you know, I learn from all that, and hopefully you can take something away from this video. I hope you guys enjoy this little change of scenery. I feel like I haven't done one of my real talks in a bit, but anyway, let's just jump right into it. So the final I failed was for my math class. As an econ major, it is required that we take a math class, and not that I'm bad at math. I have never been bad at math. In high school, I took Calc AB, BC, AP, got 5s on the AP test, killed my SAT math, killed the ACT section. So I've never particularly been bad at math, and I've never struggled with it, anything like that. But when I got to college, man, this shit hit me in the face real quick. I realized that, damn, this is the real world. Like, they're not kidding around anymore. And not that like any other school's math department isn't hard or isn't challenging, but let me tell you that Princeton math department is something else. Like, they're taking some kind of brain steroids, because that should not be possible, nor feasible, nor doable for any normal person, but it is what it is. And to be fair, I studied a fair amount. I definitely could have done more, but even the amount that I did, I felt that there was nothing else I could have done more that would have helped me do better, or you know, prepare me for the exam, because the content that was on there was just, you know, stuff that we had covered in class, but just took it to another level. And I guess I just didn't have the critical thinking skills to apply my foundational skills to what was on that problem. Anyway, that all goes to say that yes, I failed it. I think I got maybe like a 50 or 60. I mean, obviously there was a curve, but still I ended up with a C in the class. And the moral of this entire thing is that, you know, there's a couple things. Number one is that sometimes your best is not enough, right? I put in so many hours studying, cramming, getting ready for the exam, running over practice problems, working with friends, doing everything that I needed to and should have done to best prepare myself, and I still wasn't prepared. And you know, I think this is applicable to many situations, because you know, people will say, you know, at least you tried your best, blah blah blah. Like, people will still get like participation trophies. Man, in college there ain't no participation trophies. You're getting an A, B, or C. Like, that's about it, bro. You know, after dealing with that L, it took me a bit to just kind of cope with, get over, and you know, be able to talk about it like I am today. And I know it's a very personal topic and not something you see a lot of YouTubers sharing, but you know how it is on this channel. We like to keep it real. We like to keep it 100. Moving on, another huge thing I learned was that there are better things in the future. You know, I talk about failure and rejection a lot on this channel. You know, I've personally gone through a ton. I'm not successful in everything that I do, and I fall, and I always try and get back up. And especially with this math class, I realized that one, I will never have to take another math class, thank God. And two, what's in the past is in the past. A big mantra of mine is, you know, don't dwell on things that you can't control or can't change. Regardless of what happened, as long as I learn from it, learn my mistakes, learn how to grow as a person, as a thinker, as a student, then that's all that really matters. And no, I can't promise that I'm not going to fail another final in the future, but I will use what I learned and implement that into my studying habits so that that doesn't happen again. And honestly, that's applicable to so many parts of your life, whether it's college applications, jobs, internships, whatever it is. Like, there are going to be countless times that you fail, but if you don't have the strength to pick yourself back up and keep fighting, then you're not going to, one, learn from it, and two, you're not going to be able to grow from it. And I think that's honestly what failure teaches you. It teaches you how to be a better person, how to deal with things that go shitty in your life, because we're all human, we all make mistakes, and we're not always going to be perfect every single day. Number three is that you can't let one thing define your career. If I let this one C dictate the rest of my Princeton career, thinking I'm not good enough, thinking I'm not smart enough, always doubting myself, then it's hindering my growth as a student and as an intellectual. There is so much more potential for me that I know I can reach, but if I continue to dwell on this, continue to let that dictate my entire career, then, you know, it's a waste of time, it's a waste of energy, and if you know anything about me at all, then that's something that I absolutely hate. Number four, you can't be good at everything. Coming into college, I thought I was a shit because I could take photos, film videos, dress well, be cool, be sociable, and all those things, and I realized that you can't be good at everything, man. Not that I'm bad at academics, like I'm at Princeton, like I know, but there are some subjects that just aren't for everyone. Like, as a economics major, okay, maybe math is a little important, but that doesn't mean that I had to be a fucking like Nobel Prize winner in chemistry or make groundbreaking research in computer science. Like, just because the two worlds don't align doesn't mean you have to be a fucking like amazing at everything you do, like, take pride in the things that you are good at, excel in them, be the best that you can be, but don't dwell on the fact that someone else is doing better than you in your classes, because some subjects are just suited for different people. I mean, we all have different brain compositions, left brain, right brain, all that kind of stuff. And once again, comparison doesn't get you anywhere. Just because your friend did amazing in the class and didn't seem to struggle and had no problems doesn't mean that he's not doing well in another one of his classes. Maybe it's an English class or an art class or whatever. So I think what I'm trying to say here is, don't think that you have to be amazing at every single thing you do. Like, be good at a few certain things, and you know, sometimes you gotta take the L, but if you don't bounce back from that, then that's when it's a problem. Now, I am wearing my Michelle Obama shirt because this was taken in front of our library when she was an undergraduate here, which is a, you know, just a cool testament to the fact that, like, you know, Michelle Obama didn't even like her time at Princeton. She wasn't a big fan of it, which is why she doesn't come to reunions or do any huge talks here. And, you know, maybe that's applicable to where I am at this point in my life, for, you know, showing that, you know, it sucks now and there are hard times and there are failures. But, I mean, like, look at what she's doing now. She popped off. So you go, Michelle. If you're watching this, hit me. I can't even do that with a straight face. I think a few other things I just want to get off my chest is that, you know, college is hard regardless of whatever school you're at. Academics are difficult, especially on the college level, because, you know, no matter what high school you go to, it can't really prepare you for the rigor and the pace that the college courses go at, especially having to balance, you know, extracurriculars, activities, being sociable, you know, taking time to relax. All that can, you know, really bundle up and take a lot of stress on you and take a big toll on your academic and your mental and physical health. As important as GPA is, I mean, that isn't the biggest priority when you're 18, 19, 20. Like, make memories when you're in school. Like, take the time to have meals with your friends, go out and do something. Like, last weekend, like, literally last minute on a whim, I woke up, I was like, hey, let's go to New York, I'll get us an Airbnb, and we bowled out in New York for the day. And that was honestly like one of the best times I've had so far. So, you know, be spontaneous, take chances, take risks, because that's what college is for. You live and you learn to grow. And if you let your mistakes or your failures or your rejections define who you are as a person, and, you know, let that get to your self-worth, then you've lost. You've succumbed to the system. You've let the game win. And you know how it is. We don't let the game win. We're winners. Damn, I realize my posture has been really bad throughout this whole video. You know, I am a college student. I'm still 19, so I have a couple more years here. But all the things that I learn right now, I'm, you know, gonna be trying to apply to every single part of my life, continuing when I graduate and have a job or when I have a family. Like take the lesson that you learn from your L's and turn them into W's. I know I've been rambling. I didn't really plan this video out. I just kind of wanted to get this stuff off my chest. You know how we do. If you're an OG of the channel, you know what's up. You've seen these videos before. I'm close to hitting 50K. I can't believe that I'm super close. And it is frustrating because I've been putting out so much content. Like, I literally film all the time, I'm editing so many hours, and I'm still not at 50k. So please, like, hit me up with that subscribe. Like, come on, guys, I put in so much work for this. I think that about wraps up everything I want to say. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Make sure to leave a like, comment down below, you know, your thoughts, your responses, any kind of pick-me-ups would be really helpful. Subscribe, as always, don't stress, finesse. P.S. Do we want to see that on a t-shirt, on some merch? Let me know.